Damian Lillard has finally requested a trade after many years after Scoot Henderson said some questionable things after he got drafted about the ticket prices going up because he and Dame was there. Yeah, not to talk about Scoot, but Dame finally wants out of Portland. I mean, last year he signed of wanted out, but he never actually went full on. Now he's demanded a trade. Portland Trailblazers staff are saying they're doing all they can. But this is the top five places that Dame would like to go. Number one is Miami. Then you have the Knicks, the Brooklyn Nets. You have the Philadelphia 76ers, and the fifth is questionable where the fifth place is for Dame. It could be LA, but probably not. Now, they've just signed Jeremy Grant to a $120 million contract in free agency, and that's all they've done. And they could have signed someone much better than Jeremy Grant. They said they were pushing for it. But at this point, it looks like they will be hunting for a Dame trade. Dame is sick of Portland. And I think, and they're saying it's the new era of Scoot Henderson coming through. And we've already seen quite a lot of chemistry between Scoot Henderson and Shaedon Sharpe in training, and it will be a really let's see what he does in the Las Vegas Summer League against Victor Wembanyama, and we'll see if he's really proven that star point of the Portland Trailblazers starting lineup. Now, Scoot Henderson was born in 2004. He signed with the G League Ignite when he was 17. He's the number 3 pick, which went to the Blazers, and he's an NBA phenomenal. Now, he is predicted, he looks like, you know, the next Russell Westbrook. And Henderson played for Carlton J. Cal High School in Matarena. During his freshman season, he came off the bench alongside his brother CJ Senior on the team. In February 2020, during his sophomore season, Henderson scored a career-high 49 points and made the game-winning shot in a 92-91 overtime win over Miller Grove High School. Now, the real question for Scoot Henderson is, is he better than Brandon Miller, or is Brandon Miller better than him? Now, Brandon Miller went number 2 just because Melo doesn't want to be paired up with Scoot Henderson. Melo's already a ball-dominant point guard, and Brandon Miller can help on the, you know, power forward, small forward type things. So you kind of see like a point guard, power forward duo, like the Orlando Magic normally do. Now, Scoot Henderson is a phenomenal player, but he does have a couple of putbacks. See, well, he's 6'3", which is 1.91 meters, and 182 kgs. He's a 5-star prospect. His grade is 92. Rivals, let's just say he's about 13 of them. He does. He's got a real rivalry with Victor Wembanyama. Now, Dame actually is a possible place to go to is Spurs. He will probably, if the Spurs want to go in a win now situation, that would be a great place for Dame to go to. But yes, it's looking like the Scoot Henderson era, new Russell Westbrook is coming along, as Ja Morant is still flashing guns and has been suspended for 25 games, and being the Memphis Grizzlies have suspended him the whole offseason, with Marcus Smart also joining the group. So a lot of things will change as Marcus Smart is a replacement for Dylan Brooks. Now, I would also like to talk about the situation on how the Pelicans are aggressively trying to trade Zion for Brandon Miller or Scoot Henderson. Now, I don't reckon that Zion Williamson will go to the Portland Trailblazers, but there's a high chance that he could go to pair up with Melo. Now, Michael Jordan is not the team owner of the Charlotte Hornets anymore, so we could see a lot of differences in who's in charge and if they're really competing for a ring. And now we also got a report on the Portland Trail Blazers about how they traded for Bradley Beal, and they're also they will be up to get Kyrie, but Kyrie has signed a extended contract with the Dallas Mavericks, so he's not on the table anymore. But Phoenix Suns were up to grab Kyrie and run it back again because they reckoned they could win a chip with Devin Booker on the floor too. But what are the Phoenix Suns most likely going to do this offseason? And it's quite obvious. It's probably trade DeAndre Ayton. But the thing is, they've already fired the coach, which was putting him down. So he might not be traded. With Brad Beal on the team, I still don't reckon they're going to be a championship team. But also moving on to the Ja Morant situation. So they put in a full investigation, and it came out with preseason not allowed to go to by the Memphis Grizzlies, and suspended for 25 games, which make him not eligible for the NBA MVP, which now you have to play 65 games for. Now, going back to the Portland Trailblazers situation, they can trade Dame in many different ways. Many teams are up to put a package up for him, but he's most likely, in my eyes, not going to be traded. And unfortunately going to trade with the Portland Trailblazers his whole career off the past seasons, because they just haven't done anything, not bothered to do anything. But we could just see much different this season. So that will wrap today's episode up. So check out. I'm talking about the-